Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Neo Cypher Zero, and welcome back to No Man's Sky. The last time we played, we found a black hole. We also found some people by the name, well, aliens by the name of, what were they, Nada and Polo? And they gave us an Atlas Stone. And an Atlas Pass V1, so now I can get into places like this. I've been doing some farming around on planets just to kind of make some money, just generally boring stuff. It was literally just farming money. And then I did a few more things. I jumped around to some other planets to get the resources, and I got us closer to the black hole so that I can get to it in this episode without wasting too much time. So I think we're two planets away, two jumps away. I don't know why I keep saying planets, they're star systems. But yeah, we're two jumps away. I'm gonna check all the stuff in this space station real quick. Okay, these things. If you'll notice, I've gotten quite a bit more of them since last time. While I was farming on the planets for like money, I kept running into a ton of these things, and it has expanded my inventory exponentially, and it is amazing. Like, each upgrade costs 10,000 extra units every time. So like, the first one's 10,000, the next one's 20,000, the next one's 30,000, and they just keep stacking. I'm up to 210,000 now, and they are still well worth it for that one extra inventory space. Like, it is so much nicer for me to be able to carry all this stuff. I made some upgrades to my suit as well. I've got a better booster pack now. I've got a nicer shield. I've got this that lets me like breathe underwater for a limited time. All kinds of nice stuff. I think I added some stuff to my ship, but I think it was just this. The deflection enhancement, and then I added like two more things to my multi-tool, I think, just so I can mine faster without having to worry about cooldown rates. Another thing that I did that I said I was going to do in the last episode is I may have found a new starship, and here it is. It may not be the coolest thing in the world, but I finally found one that I was like, this looks cool. It gives me some extra slots. I mean, it's not too many extra slots, but you know, it was enough. So, and it looks really cool. Like, look at it. It looks like an A-wing or something from Star Wars, but I like it. And like, I still haven't really seen anything. Like, that's a cool design, but I checked that one and like the inventory is not as good as this one. So I'm just gonna stick with this one for now, and I think the first thing we ought to do is just leave this system, because I'm pretty sure there's nothing really. Oh yeah, I know what I was gonna do. Did I not go to that? I guess not. But when I jumped into this system, maybe it's not there anymore. There was a distress call. I'm not seeing it anymore though. Anyway. When I jumped into this system, there was a distress signal, and there was like a bunch of freighters being attacked, and they were shooting at me as well, so I don't know what happened to that. I guess it went away after I saved or whatever, but I don't know. Man, I was gonna do that in this episode too, and maybe have a dogfight in space or something with more than one ship. Oh well. I'm gonna go to this thing and see what it is, because apparently I haven't been to it yet. Oh, this looks cool. This looks well different from anything I've encountered before. This looks like a castle or something. Man, that's cool. Alright, all the knowledge stones are on this. Oh, and those things, I don't know if this planet is anything like the other planets I've been to. The sentinels here are really aggressive. Like, if I mine like one or two things, they'll start attacking me. Okay, and those little exclamation points that you guys see, those are, I think they're called gravitron spheres or something like that. They're worth a good bit of money, but as soon as I take one, the Sentinels go nuts on me. So those are usually the last thing I grab on the way to the ship if I want to grab one. Word for bad. What's this one? Word for vessel. I've got a bad vessel about this. Oh my god. That's one thing that's still really annoying about this game, are the uninterruptible milestones. Whoops. And the fact that, like, I can't do anything while it's showing me these milestones. It's really annoying. This looks so weird. Does this have two things? Does this do something? No, that's just decoration. Never mind. You? No? Okay, well, I didn't find anything besides the knowledge stones. Usually I'll find, like, a monolith that gives me a choice or something, but I didn't see one there. So, I'm just gonna get in my starship and, I think we're gonna leave this system. Alright guys, so this is the system I'm in now. We have one more system here, and then on the very next jump, that's our black hole. So yeah, okay, and another thing I want to remember is that we are 177,689. Actually, I better write that down. But yeah, we're 689... was it? Yeah. Light years away from the center. So hopefully when we go through the black hole, we'll check our distance to the center of the universe, or the galaxy, or whatever it is, and hopefully it'll be a lot shorter to the center. So we're gonna go ahead and jump here. So let's go! Boosh! Here we are. We're in the pink system. Oh man. I love it when the ships warp in at the same time as me. I mean, I know it's highly illogical that they would be warping in the same exact time as me. I've warped 15 times already. Jeez. Can you get off the screen now? Thank you. All right, I'm gonna rush over here to the space station real quick, because I want to get another upgrade for my suit. Here we go. There it is. Beautiful. Oh, yes. Oh, man. 220. Still worth it. Okay, this is gonna teach me a word. Unacceptable. Unacceptable! That sounded horrible. Okay, there's nothing really else in here. Except for the suit upgrade, and sometimes there's some blueprints and stuff. Weird-looking ship. I don't think I have anything to sell, but I'll check real quick. Is this a new feature they've added to the game? What the hell is the point? Well, look at me, I can spin a chair. No Man's Sky is the greatest game. Dude, you look like you're barfing two dicks at the same time. Wait, what was that? Did I just agree to marry an alien? You guys saw that, right? It said I received a picture of the alien that I will one day wed. I just wanted some stuff, man. Okay, thanks. I don't care that I've met 25 aliens. That's great. You're ruining my moment. I'm getting married, man. Oh, man. Check this planet out. It's all, like, red and white. I love that color scheme. Is there anything useful here, though? Apparently, this planet has nothing on it. Oh. Except weird-looking camel creatures. Are you hostile? Are you coming to attack me? Cruel? Oh god, it is coming to attack me! Ah! You asshole! Get out of here! No, you! Has six legs. What if I just land over here? Then what are you gonna do? I'll shoot you. Oh no! Oh, I feel bad already, but he was attacking me. Ah well. Apparently that thing's temperament was cruel. I'm not sure what that means. Maybe it just likes to torture its prey. Oh, that's crazy. Ooh, knowledge stone. Alright, I'm gonna get this real quick. I think we're gonna leave this planet. I'm not really too interested in it. Doesn't seem like... Oh, I learned the word for gas. I've got gas, guys. Okay. But yeah, there hasn't been too many like settlements or anything on this planet. Refill my thrusters. So, alright, I think we'll leave. Guys, I'm feeling the captain's itch. The itch for adventure. Captain's log, stardate April 21st. Point 2. We are plotting a new course to an unknown location. Now there's a course with some chest hair on it. Alright guys, are you ready for this? We're engaging a warp to a black hole. Let's see where this takes us. Oh man, I'm excited. Black holes are fucking scary in real life. You would never be able to survive in a black hole in real life. I mean, at least not with the technology that we have now. Here we go! Oh my god! That looks terrifying! Oh man, that's crazy. What are your ships doing out here? That's crazy. Shouldn't all this stuff be like... getting sucked into it though? Black holes have enormous gravity. I mean, that's why they're called black holes, because... they have so much mass that not even light can escape its gravitational pull. These planets should just be, like, being devoured by it. Oh man, this looks so crazy. What do I do when I go in it? I'm just gonna... is it just gonna warp me or something? Alright. I'm Matthew McConaughey now. We're in Interstellar. Oh man, I kinda just wanna take my time getting to it, cause it looks so cool. It's getting louder. It's getting brighter too, or bigger. And darker. Here we go guys. Almost there. Oh shit. Oh man, that's so cool. We're traveling through a black hole. This looks so trippy. Where's it gonna lead us? Oh. We're in a new system. There's a space anomaly over there. I'm guessing that's another Atlas interface. Oh, more ships warping in. There's a space station. We got a planet. Another planet and a moon. Okay, where was the space anomaly? Okay, right there. That's where I want to go. Oh. Space station proximity. Alright, well let's just pulse jump in that general direction. Alright, let's see what we got here. Oh god, more ships warping in. Man, this looks so cool. Okay, this looks like the same thing that we found Nada and Polo in. Wonder if they're here too. They are. Hi guys. What's up? What's gonna happen this time? Units this, units that. A strange, sad way to live a life, eh? Fill your pockets with them. We'll find out why they make all these worlds go round. Polo's muzzle breaks into a wide, warm smile at the sight of me. Maybe too wide, given we have only met twice before. Perhaps the jovial Gek feels lonely out here, with only the jittery Korvax priest for company. This time they engage me in talk of wealth. How does an economy function when somehow stretched across an entire galaxy? Just how much can those trade terminals pay out? Polo would welcome any insights. That's a good question, actually. Transmit wealth data. My fear that Polo would seize my units proves unfounded. Instead, they stare briefly at incomprehensible graphs, then guffaw at a shared joke. I didn't read the last part. Okay, well, he gave me something for it. That's cool, I guess. What's up, you're Nada, right? Nada? Maybe it's Nada. I don't know. Maybe it's a girl. Do they even have genders? Korvax Convergence Crave, non-compliant Nada Shell. Convergence illogical. Traveler data, conclusion irresistible. Galaxy shape, size, distribution error. Explore more! Nada's normally restrained form is jittering and dancing, the external symptom of an internal struggle. Iridescent lights fluoresce across their visor. At times, another entity seems to stare out. I grasp their arm firmly, and soon a familiar light pattern reasserts itself. The Korvax endlessly attempt to regain their errant shell and wipe Nada from existence, but the priest entity won't succumb until they have solved the riddle of reality. Can we find another shortcut? Like another black hole? Oh, yes. That's cool. The black holes are cool. I don't care what y'all say. Although, I wish they functioned more logically and just, like, they had, like, immense gravity. I don't know. Okay, there's something else I want to check, so let's go back outside. Okay, so here's where we are. Navigational data received. Okay. Oh, it's gonna show me another black hole. Oh, that's not too far away, I don't think. It doesn't look like it's too far away. Okay, so where are we? Now we're 176. Okay, so we're like a good 1,000 light years closer than we were. Because we were at 177,000 and then 689. Light years. Now we're 176,212. So that's like a good 1,000 light years or so closer. All right, 1, 2, 3, 4. Come on, go. 4, and then 5. Okay. Okay, so let's warp to this section and see where we can go from there. I also might stop on some of the planets and explore a bit and maybe farm and see if there's anything interesting. Alright. Because, yeah, I mean, I'm going to be passing, like, tons of planets on my way to the Galactic Center. I might as well explore some of them, you know? Let's go to this one, because it looks closer. Although, maybe it's just bigger. So, I don't know. Looks like, green water. Iridium. Here's an outpost. Let's just land here. I want to discover a planet that has, like, huge dinosaurs or something. Because I know, in one of the trailers for the game, they had giant dinosaur type creatures. They look like Brontosaurus or Brachiosaurus or whatever it's called. The one with the long neck. Okay, nothing too important here, so just some blueprints and stuff. Let's see what else we can find. Okay, guys, I haven't really found anything of note just yet. Oh, what's that? But I kind of want to check out this water. What is that up there? It's probably aluminum. But I want to check out this water and see if there's any, like, interesting creatures in it. But I'm going to go up here and check out what this is real quick. Before I do any of that. Alright, it was just aluminum. Not something I'm, like, terribly in need of. Alright, guys, let's check this out. Maybe there's some interesting creatures down here. I don't really see a way in. Unless I'm missing something. There's like, there's not even a door. Is this something that I can... No? My underwater thing stopped working. Need to recharge it. Yeah, I don't really see a way in, guys. That's a little disappointing. These are weird. Alright, I want to see if I can find some, like, animals or something. Alright, guys, well, unfortunately, I don't really see anything, so... No animals. I'm just gonna head back to the ship. Okay, not a whole lot on this planet. So... I think we're just gonna head to another one real quick. I don't know. Maybe we'll just jump. Not really feeling this system. What do you guys think? Yeah, I think we should just jump. Let's go ahead and do that. Next, please. Engage warp speed. Now, here's a planet that looks interesting. But will it have anything of value to me? I really wish you could, like, buy one of these ships. Probably be, like, ridiculously expensive. But I would love it so much. I wonder if anybody's found a planet with, like, huge creatures on it or something. That would be cool. Alright, I'm gonna check the space station out to get my suit upgrade. And then also, I might check one of these planets out, we'll see. Boop! Oh, that's so nice! Oh, it's so nice, I don't even care that it's like a quarter of my money. Oh, look at it, it's beautiful. It's so satisfying to see that now. After starting with like, what, these for the starter inventories? Man, I've purchased a lot of extra space. It's worth it! Oh my god, is it worth it? I can carry more than my ship can. How does that make any sense? I don't know. Alright guys, I'm headed to this planet because I was trying to make some warp cells, but it turns out I'm out of Heredium. So I'm gonna need to find a deposit of that somewhere. And then mine it. And I'll probably also have to stock up on some other stuff as well while I'm here. Just call 1-800-HERIDIUM for all your Heridium needs. Man, I am just finding so many of these things. And I think it's getting to the point where it's not really worth it anymore. 250,000. I think I'm gonna buy this one. And that's gonna be the last of them for quite a while. Unless I strike it really rich with something later on. I don't know, but right now, I need some plutonium. And in 1955, you could probably buy plutonium in any corner store. But here in whatever year it's supposed to be in the future, it's a little hard to come by. Actually, there's just a ton right here. Will you go away? I hate you guys. I think I got enough out of this planet. I'm gonna grab this thing of zinc, and then we're out of here. before the storm completely obliterates my shields. Hello, I didn't just kill your friend or anything. Everything's fine. I need that though. Yes, yes. Let's get out of here before we die in the storm. There's another one right there. Are you kidding me? I'm not doing it. I'm not doing it. I've got enough space for now. Man, what a drastic change. I go from, like, not having any inventory space to having, like, enough where I'm just like, I don't want any more upgrades. They're too expensive. Yeah, there doesn't seem to be much of interest on this planet. To the next place. Alright, time to get to a new system and get closer to the black hole. This thing looks like a fucking castle. This is so weird. They all used to look like boring. Now they look like freaking somebody built a castle right out in the middle of nowhere. Oh, now I'm learning Viking words, huh? Oh, now I can interact with this. I couldn't interact with that on the other one. It just teaches me a word in Viking. I don't know very many Viking words yet. I know a shit ton of Korvax words. Alright, time for another jump. We're getting closer to that black hole. That looks fucking sick. Gotta check this planet out first. I'm noticing a pattern here. All the planets that look really cool from space do not look cool once you get down here. Hello. Hi, little guys. Yep, it's kind of just a whole lot of nothing exciting. I think there's some emerald on this planet, but I'm really not in the mood for emerald farming right now, and I want to get to this black hole. So I guess I'll see you guys there. Here we go, guys. Black holes away. 176, 174. Let's see if this brings us any closer to the center of the galaxy. Man, this is cool. I heard there were black holes in the game, but, like, to discover two of them, basically in the same episode. Oh, man, it's so fucking cool looking. Guys, get away. There's a black hole there. It'll suck you in. Are there even any planets here? Yeah, there's like one planet. Screw the planet, man. I'm here for the black hole. Alright. Man, it looks so menacing. Alright. We're going through, guys. Second black hole, here we come. I feel like I'm slowing down right now. Take that, Matthew McConaughey. Oh, we're coming out of it. Alright. Okay, so let me check the map real quick. How close are we now? 174592. Yeah, that's like 2,000 light years closer. I mean, may not be that impressive, but it's definitely getting us closer. I mean, closer than we would have gone on our own. Okay. Well, I'll go to this planet here, and I think that'll be where I stop at. But anyway, guys, I think that's all the time I have for this episode. This was pretty... I think we made a lot of progress here. We found two black holes. And that was awesome. Now we met Nada and Polo again. So... anyways, I'm having fun with the series still. It's still weird to record. I've been recording for an hour and a half, and I still have no idea how long the episode's gonna be. I'm gonna try and make it as short as possible and just fit all the good stuff in. Anyway, guys, thanks for stopping by. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a like. And until next time, guys, have a nice day. Of the movie Oblivion.